Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge, and today in this video we are going to learn how to split a string only the first occurrence of a delimiter. So here we can see input string is a, this is a Java program, and here we can see space as a delimiter. So here is one space, two space, three space and four spaces are available. And our requirement is to print the output only in this format. So there will be two strings. So this will be the zero parameter and this will be the first parameter, means first index of a array. But if we are directly applying input.split method and will pass space as a delimiter, then it will break the string in five parts like this. This is a Java program, but this is not our requirement. We want to split only based on its first occurrence of this space delimiter. So we want the output in this format only. So okay, let's see how we will do. So first here I will declare one string. String input is equal to, this is a Java program. Now here our requirement is to split this string based only on first occurrence of this space delimiter. So what I will do here, first I will call input dot split method of string class, and here I will pass the delimiter as a space and it will return string of array. And it will be the output. So now I will print this output and we'll see what it will be print. So here I will just use system.out.println method, and here I will use arrays.toString method, and will pass this variable as a parameter to this method. Now I will run this application and will check the output. So it will break the string based on its all space delimiter. So once I will execute this program, we can see output here. This comma is a Java program like this. So it will print the string like this, but this is not our requirement. Our requirement is to break the string based on its first delimiter. And we just want to split the string only in only two parts, not more than two. So here we can see the output. This is a Java program. It is zero index, first index, second, third and fourth. Its length is five, but we want only two as a length. So what we will do, we can use the same method, but here we need to pass the limit in which, in how many parts we want to split this string. So if I will apply limit value as a 2, now it will just split the string based only on the first occurrence of this delimiter. So now again I will run this application and will check the output. So here now we can see the output. This is a Java program. Now it's only in two parts. So now its length is 2. This is zero index and this is first index value. And this was our requirement to split a string based on the first occurrence of a delimiter. So we can do this using the second parameter of the split method, which is the limit. So like this we can do. We are going to learn how to reverse a string in Java. For example, we have a string gain Java knowledge. Then what will be the output if we will reverse the string? This will be the output after reversing the string. So now we will learn how we can reverse a string and which one is the best approach. So here we will write a Java program to reverse a string. And here we will also see which inbuilt function we can use and which is best approaches. So what we will do, first we will do manually, like we will do iteration We will iterate each keyword and make a reverse string as a output. For example, we have an input. Now what we will do, we will declare one more string as output string that will store the result in form of reverse string. So here I will use for each loop and it will be start from its string length and it will goes up to and loop will goes up to greater than equal to 0 and here we are using iteration loop in reverse. So first it will pick its last character and will add into output 1. After that it will pick its second last character like this. It will pick and add. So here output 1 will be like output 1 dot input 1 dot char at. So here we will use input 1 dot char at index. So here we will pass its index, but it will pick its first character, so it will be length minus 1. So e is at length minus 1 index. So here what we will do, here we will just print the output 1. So now I will run this application and we'll see the output. So here what I will do, here I will also print input 1. So run this application and check the output if it is working fine or not. So here we can see the output gain Java knowledge as input and this is output in the reverse form. So this is one approach that we can use, but it is not a better approach because it takes more time. So now I will show you the second approach and we'll see which one is best. So here what we will do, input 2. So what I will do, here I will also print the time, how much time this approach is taking. So here system dot current time in milliseconds, so it is the start time. And here I will just print how much time this process is taking, time taken by iteration approach. So what I will do, system dot current time in millis, and from this time I will just subtract the start time. So it will show me the time also, how much time this process is taking in execution. So it is the first approach. So this one is the first approach. Now we will see the second approach, how it, which one is better. So what I will do, I will just copy this line and go here, second approach. So here it will be start time 2 and we'll also copy the same line from here and paste it here. And in this approach we will use the inbuilt function. And after that we will see which one is better. So what I will do, here I will take string input 2, or we can use the same as input 1, and gain Java knowledge. And what I will do, here I will use string builder class and here I will use string builder reverse method. So first here I will create string builder object and here I will pass input 2. So now our string builder object is ready. So here I will just call sp.reverse method. And after that, so here what I can use, this is parameter 1, output 1, and here we can use sb. Instead of sb, we can use output 2 and output 2. So here I will just copy the same line of codes and paste it here. So this will be the input 2 and this will be the output 2. So now I will run this application and we'll see which approach is better. So now I will start our application and check the output on console. So here we can see input 1 and this is the output 1, and time taken by iteration loop, it's 69 seconds. And in the second approach, in which we are using string builder in built function, that is reverse method, it is just taking 2 milliseconds and it is taking 69 milliseconds. And we can run it again. So here we can see it is taking 79 milliseconds, and second approach in which we are using inbuilt function is just taking 3 milliseconds. So we can say the second approach is better. We must go for inbuilt function provided by string builder class, because in this approach it's again and again creating one new object. Every time we are adding in output, it's creating new object, so it is very time consuming process. But in this approach, it is just creating one object and adding in the same object. So this is better approach. Today in this video, we are going to learn how to count number of digits in an integer without converting into string. So here it is an example. Integer input value is 129864. So how many digits in this integer? So we can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So output will be the 6. So how we will count without converting into string? So we will look into our application. So here I have just created one simple Java program, and here I will just define one integer input value 129864. So how we can count the number of digits in this integer? So what we will do, we will just divide this number by 10. So when we will divide this number by 10, so our output will be like this, 129864. So next time when we will again divide by 10, so it will return 1298. So like this, every time we need to divide by 10 up to its size will be 0. So how we will do, here I will just use while loop, and here I will define if input is greater than 0, then divide. So here input will be input divide by 10. And here we need to use one more variable to store the output. So here I can use int output. So first time it will be 0, and once it will enter inside this, so here output will be plus plus. So after each iteration, here we can print the output. So now I will just run this program and we'll see the output. So it should be 6. So here we can see the number of digits 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So like this, we can count the number of digits in an integer without converting into string. And today in this video, we are going to learn how to remove special characters from string in Java. So here we can see our input string will contain multiple special characters. So if we want to remove these all special characters and just want to leave alphabet and numeric value. Means we just want to print alphanumeric value. And or we can say we just want to remove junk values from this string. So okay, let's start to write the code and we'll see how these all special characters will be removed or junk data will be removed from this input string. And we can see this type of output without any special character or junk character. So let's start to write the code. So here first I will create one class, new Java class. So we can name this class remove special characters from string. So in this class I will just declare one main method. So here I will just define the main method and here I will just define input string. The input string will contain multiple special characters. So I will use this string as the input value. So here we can see there are multiple special characters and these are alphabets gain, and here we can see Java, and here is knowledge. So we will remove all the junk characters and just will show the output as gain Java knowledge. So what I will do here, I will just declare input dot replace all. So here I will replace all the special characters with empty values. So what I will do here, I will just use regex. So here we just want to save alphabets. So what I will do here, I will define A to Z. So it will identify and all caps and all small case letter I want to save, and also want to print numeric values and any other values that is not included in alphabets and numerics. We just want to remove the from this string. So here I will define note, and here I will just replace this regex with empty string. So here I will just assign new value to same string, and here I will just print the output. So if also want to print the space, then we just need to define here one space. So it will save A to Z or 0 to 9 and save also space. So once I will run this application, we can see the output. So here we can see the output is gain Java knowledge and there is no special character. So we have just printed space and all characters that included A to Z and 0 to 9 in small case and in uppercase, both we have handled. So this was all about how to remove special characters from string in Java. And today in this video, we are going to learn how to find minimum and maximum number from array in Java. For example, we have a integer of arrays that contains value 77, 90, 55, 11, 108, 33. And from these number of arrays, we need to find minimum value. So we can see here minimum value is 11. And now we need to find the maximum value. So here we can see the maximum value is 108. Now we need to write the code to find the minimum and maximum value from array. Okay, let's get started. So first I will create one class, new Java class, and we can name this class as find maximum and minimum value from array. And inside this main class, I will declare main method. And here are multiple ways to find the minimum and maximum value from array. But here I will follow just two approaches. First one is by using inbuilt function provided by Java 8 library. And second approach without using inbuilt methods, how to find minimum and maximum value in array. So first approach will be using Java 8 inbuilt methods. So first I will declare one integers of array, and I will give this array name is numbers, and I will just copies from here. So I have copied these numbers. Now I will go back and will just paste these numbers here. So now what I will do, first I will convert these arrays into list of integer. So I will give this name numbers list, and here I will use arrays.asList method, and here I will pass my arrays object. Now we need to import this list into our class. So after converting these arrays into list, now we need to sort this list. So after sorting, so our first character will be the minimum value and last character will be the maximum value. So how I can sort? Here I will use Java 8 library to sort the elements. So what I will do, first I will convert this numbers list into stream, and here I will apply sorted method, and then I need to store the sorted element into new list, and here I will use this list of integer to store this object. So here we can say sorted list. So in this sorted list, it will store all the array element in ascending order. So our first element will be the minimum value and last will be the maximum value. So here I will print first character and last character. So sorted list minimum value will be at index 0, sorted list dot get index 0, and next what I will do, I will print the maximum value that will be at last index. So here I will just call dot size method and will minus 1. So sorted list dot get so now I will run this application and will check minimum value should be 11 and maximum should be 108. So now I will run and check the output on the console. So here we can see minimum value is 1 and the maximum value is 108. So like this we can get minimum and maximum value by using Java 8 inbuilt functions. If there is any requirement without using inbuilt function how we can get minimum and maximum value, for that I will write logic here. So second approach will be like without using inbuilt function how we can get minimum and maximum value. So for this I will use same integer arrays, but what I will do, first I will store this first value into one variable. So here I will declare one variable, that name will be max, and here I will get numbers of 0. So I will assume that it's our maximum value 77. And next what I will do, after storing this value into integer, I will compare this value with all other values. So if this value is greater than, next value is greater than 77, then I will store 90 into max variable. Then I will again compare 90 with 55. If 55 is greater than 95, then I will replace, otherwise not. So here we can see 55 is smaller than 90. So we will compare 90 with next variable, that is 11. So 11 is also smaller. So now we will go again next step, we will compare with 108. So here we can see 108 is greater than 90. So what we will do, we will replace this value, and now next time this value will be 108. So like this we will compare with each element of array, and then in the last we will print the original value, what is the maximum value. So here I will iterate. So our iteration will be start from first index, because we are already storing zero index value into max variable. So it will start from 1 and it will goes up to numbers dot length, and it will be up to last index with incremented operator. So here we will apply the condition, if numbers of I is greater than maximum value, then we will replace the value, then we will update this max value only. So here our new max value will be numbers of I. So when all the variable will be checked, after that we will just print the maximum value. So here I will just copy and paste. So here we will just print max value. So now I will run this application and will check, here max value should be 108. So now I will again run this application. So now here we are not using any inbuilt function to find the maximum value of array. So here we can see the maximum value in array is 108. So this is the approach, that is without using inbuilt function. So here it will iterate all the elements. So how this logic is working? So first we can see our first index numbers of 0 value is 77, and we have start the iteration from first index variable. So our first index numbers of 1 is 90. So here we will check, 90 is greater than 77. The condition is true, 99 is greater than 77. So here we can see the condition is true. So it will update the max value. Now our max value will be 99 90. So next time 90 will compare with 55. So here we will check, 90 is 55 is greater than 90, so it's false, so it will not go. So next we will compare 90 with 11. So here we will see 11 is greater than 90, so condition is false, so it will not go inside. So next we will compare 90 with 108. So here we will see 108 is greater than 90, the condition is true, so max value will be updated, so it will be 108, and here also it will updated 108. Then next we will compare 108 with 33. So 33 is greater than 108, it's false, so it will not update. So after that it will just print the max value is 108. Like this we can also print the minimum value without using inbuilt function. We just need to reflect this check. So here it will just check the minimum value. So here if I will write minimum and will run this application, so this time it will just print the minimum value is 11. So now here we will see on the console, so minimum value is 11. So like this we can get the minimum value and maximum value from array with the help of inbuilt functions or without inbuilt functions. Okay, thanks for watching this video.